Hello everyone, it's Seth, probably better known as Saffron Olive, and it's time for another Instant Deck Tech. So as you know, Monday means it's Modern Monday here in Instant Deck Tech land, and I don't even know what to say about this deck. It probably should be on Wildcard Wednesday or something like that, because this deck is absurd, and we're talking about Unexpected Tron. Comes to us from Shibazaki Touma, who took it to an undefeated finish in a small Japanese tournament, so congrats to Touma on a super sweet deck. A quick reminder before we break down Unexpected Tron for Modern. If you enjoy this deck and you want to see it main to videos, take a minute, click the like button, the subscribe button, leave a comment, anything you can do to support your deck, because whichever deck is most popular gets a shot at being made into videos next week. So Unexpected Tron starts off looking like any Tron deck. We've seen a million different versions of Tron. Normal Tron, Eldrazi Tron, Blue Tron, Gifts Tron, so many different variants, and they all have one thing in common, and that is they are using Urza's Power Plant, Urza's Tower, and Urza's Mine to make a bunch of mana really, really quickly. So, like most Tron decks, not only do we have the lands themselves, we have Expedition Map to tutor up our missing Tron pieces. If we can just play one of each Tron piece over the first three turns of the game, that's 7 mana by turn 3, more mana as the game goes along. So we're looking to make a bunch of mana with our Tron pieces, but in all fairness, Tron is like sort of a weird backup plan. Like, we definitely want the mana from Tron, but we're also kind of like a normal ramp deck too. We have 4 Simic Signets, we have 3 Explorers to give us extra Tron pieces, extra land, draw some cards. Sakura Tribe Elder is another ramp spell for basic lands, and this stuff is all pretty uncommon for Tron decks. Normally you're just playing Tron pieces, trying to assemble Tron quickly as possible. You're not ramping for non-Tron lands with Sakura Tribe Elder. So why are we using these Simic Signets and Explorers and Sakura Tribe Elders? That's because our deck is looking to cast Unexpected Results. So Unexpected Results, I think we played a deck with Unexpected Results a long time ago. It is maybe the highest variance card in Magic. So 4 mana, sorcery, you shuffle your library first, so you can't manipulate it, there's no brainstorming stuff back with Jace. Reveal the top card of your library. If it's a non-land card, you get to cast it without paying its mana cost. If it's a land card, it goes on the battlefield, and then you return Unexpected Results back to your hand, so then you can do it again the next turn. So I will say the Unexpected Results has some nice upside in a Tron deck, because our misses are using Unexpected Results as like a really weird ramp spell. Basically, our deck, we have the Simic Signets, we have the Sakura Tribe Elders, we have the Explorers, but we don't really have that many non-land cards that are bad hits. So we either hit a Tron land, or what are the other possible hits for Unexpected Results? And this is where the deck gets super crazy. So first off, we have Omniscience. Omniscience, a million mana, 10 mana, but it just lets you cast non-land cards from your hand without paying their mana cost. So everything you can cast is free. Obviously, this lets you cast your Unexpected Results again and again and again, and all kinds of other things. So what are we trying to Unexpected Results into outside of Omniscience, or cast once we have Omniscience? And that is a Parade of Eldrazi Titan. So 4 Emrakul the Aeon's Torn, 3 Emrakul the Promised End, so 7 Emrakuls. If you're somehow not familiar with Emrakuls, if you cast them, they are very likely to win you the game. Emrakul the Aeon's Torn annihilates the way your opponent's board. It gives you an extra turn. It's a huge flyer. Emrakul the Promised End steals your opponent's turn, also a huge flyer. So either one of these are pretty good. Unexpected Results does let you cast the card, so you are getting the cast trigger off your Emrakuls, but it doesn't stop there. Just Emrakuls are not enough. We also have 3 Ulamog the Ceaseless Hunger, 2 Ulamog Infinite Gyre. So if we get unlucky and our Unexpected Results whiff on our Emrakul, maybe we get an Ulamog, exile away some permanents, eat away our opponent's library, or annihilate away their board. But that's not all. We also have a Kozilek Butcher of Truth and Kozilek the Great Distortion. So if you've been keeping track at home, that is 14 Eldrazi Titans. 14 Eldrazi Titans! We have more Eldrazi Titans in this deck than we have Tron lands in this deck. It is so ridiculous. So I think the main idea is, with a million Eldrazi Titans, our odds of hitting an Eldrazi Titan with our unexpected results are not that bad. They're not good. We still have lands. We still have other things. It's like our maybe 25%, depending on the exact makeup of our deck. However, that's a pretty reasonable shot. Like, if you're going to try to break the math on unexpected results, one way to do it is just make a full quarter of your deck Eldrazi Titans, because that means there's a pretty reasonable shot you're going to hit an Eldrazi Titan with your unexpected results. And like I said, worst case, maybe we get Omniscience. Worst case, this is where the Tron lands come in. We can always just play Tron lands, play some Sakura Tribe Elders, and hopefully just ramp into our Eldrazi naturally. And that's why we have Ulamogs and Kozileks and whatnot as well. They're only 10 mana, 11 mana. I say only loosely, but only 10 mana or 11 mana, which means it only takes 4, maybe 5 Tron lands to cast them, when Emrakul costs a lot of mana, takes a lot of Tron lands to cast it. But in theory, we could just hard cast a Kozilek Butcher of Truth or Ulamog the Ceaseless Hunger on turn 4 if we just have the nut draw. Double Urza's Tower, Urza's Mine, Urza's Power, but that's 10 mana on turn 4. So spin the wheel on unexpected results, maybe an Omniscience. Worst case, just try to hard cast our 14 Eldrazi Titans and win the game. Otherwise, we have Blast of Genius. Blast of Genius looks really weird. It's a lot of mana. It's 6 mana, you get to draw 3 cards. Then you discard a card and deal damage to a creature or player equal to that card's converted mana cost. So in theory, we can just 15 our opponent's face if we discard an Emrakul or shoot down a Death Shadow or something like that. As far as the mana base, we talked about the Tron lands helping us cast our stuff, Breeding Pool, Stomping Grounds for fixing, a bunch of basic lands because we need to be able to tutor them out with our Sakura Tribe Elder. In the sideboard, we have more ways to maybe get Eldrazi Titans on the battlefield. Dictate of Karametra just doubles up our mana, essentially, so we get additional mana when we're tapping our lands. A little awkward with Tron lands, not as exciting as you would think, but still, it's a way to make even more mana, just hard cast our stuff. Summoning Trap, good against blue decks. Opponent counters one of our spells. I'm not exactly sure what creature spell they would be countering, because all of our creature spells are Eldrazi Titans, I guess Sakura Tribe Elder. But in theory, if they decide to remand our Sakura Tribe Elder, we get a free roll on our Summoning Trap. Worst case, it's only 6 mana with 14 Eldrazi Titans in our deck. Pretty good shot that we hit one. Negate to fight through counter magic. Nature's Claim to deal with artifacts and enchantments. And that is Unexpected Tron for Modern. That's our instant deck tech for today. I have no idea if this deck can actually work. On paper, I don't think it can, but that's why it's unexpected results. The results are unexpected, so you never know. You never know what happens. Anyway, that's been our instant deck tech. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will talk to you soon. Thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, help us out by clicking that like button down below. And to keep up on all the latest and greatest, click that subscribe button. And don't forget to hit that bell icon to get alerts whenever we have new videos. And if you want to, check out some of our other sweet videos here and here.